This is Carolyn Choate for Kalcha. After 3 years of lifestyle programming featuring food and wine, fine and performing arts, and travel in and around Greater Boston, you know, I can be, well, campy. And that's a good thing, because this week I'm taking the superlative to a whole new level from the 2017 Boston RV and Camping Expo, where yours truly felt like a kid in a candy store.
Almost 400,000 units are going to be sold this year. Amazingly, that is more units than we have sold in any year in the last 39 years. So to say that this industry is on a rebound is an understatement. We have everything in the show from a $10,000 pop-up to a $400,000 diesel pusher, and everything in between. There are 9 million RVs on the road today. So it's a lifestyle, it's a great lifestyle for those who haven't yet jumped into it.
We're just having a boys' day out with Nana. And I just bought my first camper in the fall.
Congratulations.
Thank you. And I was pretty excited to come here and see all the different styles.
Mm-hmm. Well, what, there sure is a lot of them here. There What's your impression, sir?
There's a lot to look at. Yeah.
Well, I'm new to camping, so it's all very interesting to me. But I love the new colors and the bright interiors.
Now, you look about my age, so let me ask you this. Why this juncture in your life have you taken the RV route? Why now?
Freedom. I own a business, and the only way for me to get away and take my dogs with me is a camper.
Nana isn't alone in her quest for freedom through camping. In fact, she's part of a national surge in girl camping. But no one in the country lives, breathes, and RVs with more passion than Janine Pettit, whose multi-social media platforms directed towards women make her a popular speaker and industry spokeswoman. Well, this pretty much sums up why we love what we do. My guest is Janine Pettit, and she's with Girl Camper. Thanks for joining me.
Thank you, Carolyn. I'm thrilled to be here.
Truly, when we talk about Girl Campers, it is a movement of which you are the founder. Tell us, take us back in time and how and why.
Well, I'm not the founder. I'm sort of the spokesperson for Girl Camping. The founder of Girl Camping, I don't know, well, who is it? Is it the Girl Scouts? Is it
Eve?
Yeah. I mean, haven't women been camping their whole lives? But I became a member of Sisters on the Fly, which is a girl camp. It's my favorite girl camping group. And it was founded by Maury Sussman and her real-life sister, Becky Clark. And it was just a couple of them fly fishing in Wyoming. And they said, let's call ourselves Sisters on the Fly, because we fly fish and we're on the fly, we're on the go. And I joined that group because my husband doesn't like to camp. He said, oh my gosh, your people have found you. You've got to join this group immediately and stop bugging me to go camping with you. And that was 12 years ago.
Well, hats off to him, number one, for wanting you to be happy and partake in what you enjoy. And then number two, however, for then encouraging you ever after, because it has blossomed into the second wonderful chapter of your life.
It absolutely has. I mean, if I had to create a job for myself, I wouldn't have imagined I could have a job this cool. So it sort of unfolded in a way that I didn't make anything happen, and it's a great job.
Blogging, podcasting, guest speaking, going around the country. We're in a beautiful vintage camper right now, but she takes her own with sponsorship. Oh my gosh.
So I'm very lucky that I have people who understand that the girl camping movement is really a demographic. It's a new buying demographic in the RV industry. And my show is sponsored by Progressive Insurance and Little Guy Worldwide, who really want to promote girl camping and make women know that they have a voice out there.
Always wanted to go to college, here's your chance. Camper college.
So what I do is I basically help women get into the RV movement. So, you know, we're sitting in this beautiful vintage camper, and if you're at any social media at all, you know that everybody is pinning these, posting them, saving them, and then these women don't know how to get started actually buying one and using them. Camper college is something I do with RV dealers, and what it is it's just an evening designed to demystify trailer ownership. So based on the email I get from my podcast listeners, people are afraid of two things. They're afraid the trailer is going to fall off the hitch. That's a big fear if you don't know anything about trailering. And the other thing is they're afraid of towing. So I partner with these dealerships and I help them to, I bring in the women and they show them, this is how the hitch goes on. This is the safety pin. If you have the right ball and this is all hitched up, the chances of this thing coming off the hitch are very, very small. The other thing is trailering. People are afraid of towing, but towing is a skill set. It's like anything else. My dad had this saying, I get up in the morning, I put my pants on one leg at a time. Everybody who is out there towing had a starting point. It cannot be that hard, or U-Haul would not give everybody who comes in with a valid driver's license a trailer to tow away after a 20-minute video. I drove my parents' 24-foot motorhome from New Jersey to Illinois when I was 21 years old. I didn't have fear, but other people do. And I initially thought, I hate that term about women's empowerment, because there's this suggestion that at some point I was disempowered, and I never was. But there are women who were. They just don't have someone in their life who has their back. And that's what the Girl Camping movement is all about. It's like, hey, we'll be your tribe. We will help you. I'll help you learn how to hitch up that trailer. I'll help you learn how the systems work. I'll show you where to plug it in. I'll show you how to back it into the site. I'll show you how to get it out of the site. I'll show you how to stabilize it. Once you know you've got someone who's going to help you, doesn't matter how long it takes you to get it down. You've got a tribe, and they're going to help you.
If someone's listening right now, how can they find you anywhere?
Well, the best place to find me is on my podcast, which is Girl Camper, and it's on iTunes and all the usual outlets for podcasts. So the podcast is all about helping women get started in the girl camping movement. So that's the best place to find me. I also have a blog, which is girlcamper.com. And this is what I say to a lot of women, too. What is the whole idea of camp like a girl? You know, I'm not trying to win a battle with nature. I don't need to sleep on the ground in a tent to prove that I love the outdoors. I want to enjoy the outdoors, and I want to do it in comfort, and that's what the RV lifestyle is all about. So whether you're in a little tab or you are in a Class A motorhome, being able to hit the road and know that you are self-contained, you have a hard shell over you, you can go wherever you want to go.
So where's your next trip? Let's end on that.
Well, this year I'm taking a big bucket list trip. I'm going to be gone for 5 weeks. I am hitting...
Wait. What are we talking about, a bucket list? You look about my age. You look pretty young to me.
Now, well, I'm 50-ish is what we like to say. But I am hitting the road with a bunch of girls, and we are caravanning up to northern Michigan first and taking... going over the Upper Peninsula.
Oh, I love it there.
And then we're going down and across. We're going through the Dakotas, and we're going to do Rushmore and the Badlands and Devil's Tower and Yellowstone, and then we're taking a southern route home, and we're going to be gone for 5 weeks.
Well, it's just been a real pleasure meeting you, and I hope that my viewers have a chance to meet you through all the different ways, the podcast, the blogging. And happy trails.
Oh, Carolyn, I'll see you on the highway.
You will.
Okay.
Zach from Pete's RV. Are you from Indiana?
I'm actually from Vermont, but we do have a dealership in Schererville, Indiana, and South Windsor, Connecticut as well. So.
I love Vermont. I lived there 8 years. What part?
We are in South Burlington, Vermont.
That's where we used to live.
Look at that.
But we camp every other year at Button Bay.
Oh, really? Yeah,
love
that's a great
there.
Spot. That is a great spot.
Best campground. But what I love about, two things that came to mind as I walked by here. I love this big window.
It is fantastic.
So often campers don't have big windows. Why is that?
You know, I wouldn't be able to tell you, but what I can tell you with this Wolf Pop is it just lets a lot of natural sunlight. It really complements the color well. You know, great view if you're by a lake or anything like that. Biggest window in the industry.
And obviously you can put something down if you don't, you know, want people seeing you, you know.
They do.
If you, you know, maybe eat breakfast in the nude, I don't know.
Exactly.
You can always put it down. But You don't see windows like this in a lot of campers.
You don't really, and that's what's great about the Wolf Pup. For the price point, it just has a lot of great things in it.
That brings me to my second point, Zach. I love the names of campers. You know, it's like how they name tornadoes and storms.
Right.
Wolf Pup, and you know, you look around Cherokee and etc. All the names just really kind of, sometimes they blow my mind.
They do. I don't know how they come up with them all.
There you seems can write a comedy skit on them.
I agree. There's a new one every year. Somehow they keep coming up with them.
Do you have
them.
A favorite?
You know, I do love them all. I love selling them. You know, I love being able to just go in and get everyone into lifestyle. You know, it's hard to pick a favorite.
Thanks for joining
us. Of course. Thank you. I appreciate it.
I don't have to tell you what the ills of society are today. We all live it every day. The benefit of our being is it brings you back to what life used to be like. When you get your kids or your grandkids or you get yourself into a campground, you forget everything else around you. The kids get off their phones, they get off their computers, they go out and understand nature, they go out and meet friends. You know, when we grew up, you knew the neighborhood and the neighbors knew each other and they knew the kids. You don't know your neighbors anymore.
So what does it mean, ask me about price matching?
What that means is that if there's anything on the floor here that's comparable to any of the products that I have currently on the floor here at this demonstration show, I'll price match it. Apples to apples.
So it's kind of like taking coupons from one store to another.
That's correct, and it also means that with my pricing, however, the delivery is included, the delivery prep is included, it's not charged to the customer as a second add-on to the home. We also provide a two-hour delivery process in the middle of their pickup. When they come to pick it up, we spend about 2 hours demonstrating the home to them, the electronics, the remote controls.
I will need that.
Yeah. A lot of consumers need that, believe it or not. They need that when they're picking up any of the newer models because the technologies are changing so rapidly. They're making some of the older homes quite obsolete. So this is a really good time to start trading in and start bringing the older homes to us.
This is a really good time to ask your name and where you're from, actually.
My name is Laura, and I'm working with Campers Inn. We're 16 stores on the East Coast here, which means you can take...
There's one in my neck of the woods, Merrimack.
That's correct. There's one in Kingston, there's one in Raynham, and there's one in Union, Connecticut.
Mm-hmm.
What that means to the consumers here on the East Coast is that they can have their warranty or their service work done at any of our 16 facilities all across the Northeast. We are looking to branch out across the United States. The difference between us and some of the other bigger RV vendors is that we're still family-owned. We just turned 50 this last year. We're very proud of that. We had our 50th anniversary. We're still family-owned, one single family, the Hirsch family. So if you have a problem with your RV and you let me know, I'm going to get right with David Hirsch or with Jeff Hirsch, and you're going to go straight to the CFOs of the company.
Well, this camper right here, the vintage, I see this return to the love of vintage.
The love of vintage is making a very big comeback. We see a lot of our beachcombers going to the vintage. A lot of people that go out to the beaches and spend their time there. A lot of people that want to go back out and tour Route 66 for whatever reasons. They're nostalgic. They want to go back to the time of when they could tow their campers with a Volkswagen. We want them to be lighter weight. We've gone to the vintage so that they can be towed, a lot of them with smaller SUVs, which is where the millennials are coming into play.
More Humvees and
No, they're concerned.
The larger.
They're very concerned about the environment. They're very concerned about gas consumption. They're very concerned about their kids getting too much TV or too much stimulus. And a lot of them will go to the vintage because it's not loaded with televisions. It's not loaded with aesthetics that are taking away from the family time, if that makes sense.
Another thing that I noticed, where was I, is this sort of neat little options that this is, you know, outside the unit that, you know, if you're out by the lake or, you know, you're maybe cleaning fish or, you know, grabbing a beer, it's it's outside and accessible. It's kind of cool.
That's very true. I will tell you something else that's very delightful about this is a lot of campers, believe it or not, will come in and say they like the idea of it because they don't get the odors inside their home when they're cooking outside. And they like it because...
Oh, is this the stove?
That's the little grill top. And the other reason we do the outside kitchen, I'll tell you a little inside secret, is because it helps to keep the nosy Nellies out of the inside of your home. If you're grilling outside, sometimes your neighbors want to come over and hang out with you. This just gives you a little more space to do this outside. We're very particular about where we think about putting the awnings. So when the awnings are dropped, it's a full screen house and it's all under protection. We recommend that people put an indoor-outdoor carpet underneath so they're not taking things in and out. As far as dirt or debris, that kind of thing. And it really, really is conducive to some really fun outdoor living.
In this age of little houses,
yes,
many people see why do I need the McMansion and are sizing down and actually living in some of these and quite comfortably, constructing a life of consumerism. And I say more power to them.
I would agree with you, and I will tell you the other thing, too, about these little guys that a lot of consumers don't know is they actually can be tax deductible. The loans on them can be considered a second home, and if they're considered a second home, that's a tax deduction.
Did you hear that, honey?
So with a tax deduction, what that means is you're reinvesting your tax deduction back into your home and maximizing vacation time with your family versus going overseas, places like that. There's plenty to see in our country here that we could really be taking advantage of and really enjoying and taking the benefits of a small condo with you without the condo fees or without the property taxes.
Well, then I have one more note to end on, and that is I would venture to say that most, if not all, are made in the USA.
That is correct.
You're here.
That is correct. They are supporting American made.
Where's
jobs.
The American flag? Where's the little thing to hold the American flag?
We should absolutely be focusing on
yes!
that more because we are using this. This is a platform to help rebuild America. America's coming out of an extraordinarily difficult recession. And this is a really great way to put our time and energy back into our country, not just in the build of these, but in using them to visit various campgrounds, visit various sites here in the United States that have long since been forgotten, like Route 66, which is coming back up again.
For someone who didn't want to be on camera, wow, she's going to be our next spokesperson. We're hiring her on the weekends. I'm with Spencer, and we are at the almighty temple of Airstream. I'm bowing down. What's it like to work for the very tippy top of the RV mountain?
It's the best. It's the best. You get to sell the best product. You get to, you basically get to help people have extremely awesome adventures throughout the United States. They get to travel. Adventure.
Well, you're kind of young. So you're starting out at, I won't ask your age, but you're starting out young, helping those realize mm-hmm. the ultimate RV dream.
Yes, yes I am.
So I'm jealous, dang it.
I'm only 20.
You're only 20?
20 years old.
Okay, so at that time, since you are so young, mm-hmm. I'm going to press you on this one.
Sure.
At that time, if he said or anyone said the word Airstream, mm-hmm. did you know the extent of the bubble of Airstream?
No, not at all.
Oh, so how long did it take before the register's going in your head going, wow, this is the ultimate product?
The first time I saw them, I was like, these things look like spaceships. They're really cool.
Mm-hmm.
They look like they're unlike any other.
Let's go in.
RV.
Let's go in.
Yeah,
I'm drooling now. So we're going to interrupt your dinner here with a little TV interview. So you don't have to go if you don't want to.
I know.
but Spencer, mm-hmm. so I mean, this is like a hotel on wheels.
It is. It's very much comparable to a home on wheels, yeah. The biggest thing that really stands out is how well they hold their value.
Yeah.
Airstreams hold their value 80% over 10 years.
This is a little financially out of reach for 20-year-olds.
Sure.
How much does this model cost?
This one, we have it for about $75,000, but for the show, we have it for only about $60,000.
Hurry up. A couple more days. $60,000, that's a big piece of cake.
Yeah.
You could buy it, put a nice down payment on a house.
Yeah, that's true. But we also do financing, too. So if you were to finance over 50 years, you could get it for as long as, if it was over $50,000, you could get it for about 20 years. It's kind of like a mortgage.
How are sales? I mean,
good.
Sales are good.
Yeah.
But are sales good in the 50, in the 60 age category and over? Or what about the 60 and under category?
They're kind of all over the place. We have around, I'd say the main demographic is around the 50-60 range, and then some a little higher and some a little lower too.
Did you say, Spencer, that this is, say, the mid-priced model for what's here?
Okay.
What's next door?
Definitely. You mean right here?
Or this? I mean, when you talk about the Mercedes of campers, this is the Mercedes, literally the Mercedes of campers.
Yeah, it's true. Yeah, this is the Interstate. So we, at Airstream of Nashua, we mostly do the travel trailers. Now, the travel trailers, and we let these people do the interstates, which are a little bit up north. So, but we mostly specialize in the travel trailers because they will hold their value longer as well, because motorhomes will actually decrease in value a lot quicker. Anything with an engine is going to decrease.
I see. So, moving to this Airstream, this is obviously longer. And more bells and whistles, more people could sleep in it.
Sure.
So let's take a tour in this one. What would you like for dinner tonight? You name it, because in this kitchen, I could make anything. Couldn't I?
Yeah, you can. This Airstream at least features a full stove right here. And the cool thing about it is that the burners all around it are all sealed in. So it's very easy to clean up. My apartment at home, it's got like those little dishes underneath it, right? And you get a little grease stain or something. It's very hard to clean out. You don't get that problem with
it. So is one of the perks by working at this dealership that you get an Airstream?
I wish. That would be nice. You also get the oven at the bottom here. You can also get a convection microwave, which has the same basic purpose as an oven, but you can also use it for different things as well, like, you know, heating up your coffee.
Okay, where's the jacuzzi?
Close. We have a microwave hidden in this model, which is very nice. Some of the models don't have both the microwave and the oven, but this is nice, and it's also very concealed and out of the way too.
So, is this a queen size?
It is. This is the beautiful queen size bed, and it also lifts right up underneath it for additional storage.
Cool.
Airstreams have 30% more storage than any other trailer on the market.
This guy's well educated. He went to Camper College too.
Yeah, I actually went to the factory where they make Airstreams. Each Airstream takes 250 to 300 man hours to make, and the classics take even longer, around 350.
Interesting.
Yeah?
Interesting. That's interesting. So the shower and the toilet, I'm guessing, are then two different rooms. That's nice. It's more efficient, you know, traveling in groups. And I'm storing, this is a closet shower. A closet storage.
Mm-hmm.
Very nice.
Cool.
Well, thank you, Spencer, for a wonderful tour.
You're welcome.
Here's your next buyer right here. And he's a Bruins fan, right? Well, Spencer's ready to sell it for you. Let's see, how much money's in your piggy bank? This one is only $82,544. You got that in the bank?
No.
Good luck. We've been seeing a lot of campers, talking with campers today, but now we're going to talk with Sandy Pines and with Beth Geary. She's the head of marketing there, because you are perhaps one of the most preeminent campgrounds in the shore of Maine, and for many interesting and unique reasons.
Yeah, we've got a beautifully wooded campground, really private sites. We have a little element of glamp, so we're really calling ourselves an RV resort. We're going to have a lobster pound with fresh Maine lobster on site. If you want lobster for dinner, call us up. I need 6 lobsters, and we'll drop them off at the specified time. You can have your lobster, and we'll come clean up the mess. We're going to have paddle boards, kayaks. We border a beautiful salt marsh, and our campers can use that amenity. Farm stand with fresh local produce, a concierge to help make local plans and reservations. We just really want to create an atmosphere where people can go relax.
This seems really more up my alley.
Yeah, I mean, we're really trying to elevate the experience. We've got a really creative team who loves the luxury experience when they travel. We're definitely going to have some of those more conventional things that you mentioned, though. Our pool is going to have salt water in it, though, and our game room is going to have classic games like Pac-Man in it. So we definitely have, you know, a variety of people to cater to, and we want to have something for everyone. But in terms of the level of service and the level of amenities, it's going to be elevated. We're in Kennebunkport, after all, you know.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
So, and keep it at that level.
When you talk about, you know, the resort experience, you know, there are properties for sale all the time around the world. Mm-hmm. It's so cool to think that, and it didn't enter my mind that campgrounds are for sale and that a group of people would invest and sit around a table and enjoy and just be so excited about creating an experience for us campers out here.
Yep.
In a way that had not been done before. So can I ask, what was it before this?
It was a campground, more of a traditional campground, and the owner is a luxury hotelier and real estate developer who spent his childhood camping and always said, you know, I want to own a campground that can provide an incredible nostalgic experience like I had growing up. And this campground happened to go up for sale. It's in our backyard. He has 2 hotels down the road, and it had great bones and great already existing things that we could work with and just enhance a little bit to create this more of a resort environment.
So this will be your first summer in reality.
Yes, yep.
Well, I've been, you know, standing around a little bit talking and seeing the interchange and interface with you, and obviously your classic vintage camper is drawing a lot of attention, but people are really interested in what you have to say, and you're obviously a great saleswoman.
Yeah, thanks. No, they are, and I think what's cool about our campground is we have the transient sites for tents and RVs. We really want to create a great base of seasonal campers with us, too. We've got some park models for sale. So we've got something for everyone. And
really?
Yeah.
So let's stand up a minute. When I look at this map, for mm-hmm. example, I'm seeing that it's color-coded.
Mm-hmm.
And so there's specific places for RVs,
mm-hmm.
specific places for tents, mm-hmm. I'm assuming.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'm guessing, like, the optimum, like, shoreline possibilities, right?
Yep. Well, so this abuts conservation. So this is all conservation land here, so it's never going to be developed. It's lush, it's wooded, it's beautiful, it's quiet. This is salt marsh, and then the ocean is right here.
We'll
have kayaks and paddle boards that people can take out in the salt marsh. And it's really cool where this is our first year, because this is a map of where we think we're going to end up in terms of the structures and the particular sites. These are our more premium 50-amp.
Are you already selling?
We are just beginning to. Our booking engine is going up in the next couple weeks. These are designated for park models, but for year one, somebody has an RV they want to pull into one of those sites, it's like first come, first serve for this first year. Yep. Yeah.
Well, we're really excited to hear about this happening in Kennebunk. And, you know, it's Kennebunkport. It's really rare to find a great campground near the ocean, near the water, period.
Yeah.
So That's the first thing on my list.
Yeah, we're 1 mile from Goose Rocks Beach, which a lot of people, when they go to the beach in the Kennebunks, they go to Gooch's Beach or Kennebunk Beach, beautiful beaches. This is kind of a little hidden gem, so it's going to be nice to let our campers go experience this little piece of Maine that not many people get to.
Well, if it's a hidden gem, I'm glad you polished it. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it.
I'm Carolyn Choate. Thanks for watching Caught Ya, campers.